Before moving to the next topic, we have to learn one theory part, that is jump statements. What is it, Sharath? What is it?
Jump statement.
Jump, J-U-M-P. Jump statements. So write down the heading as Pavitra, turn on your video. Mohammed Irfan, turn on your video. Last class, I called you many times and there was no response from you. Mohammed Irfan. Do you ever participated in long jump? Mohammed Irfan, question to you.
No.
High jump?
No.
No. Any long jump, high jumpers are here? Manuel? No one. Nobody is interested in sports. Girls? No one. Or you're not, you don't want to tell this at this time, isn't it? So what is the meaning of this long jump? Why it is called jump? Why it is not called walk? Long walk. High walk. Why it is called jumping? What can be the reason, Ashish? Benny? In films, you can see the hero will be jumping from the 10th floor or Burj Khalifa to the ground floor, and he won't be getting anything, no hurting. So graphics, again, you are using computer. So that is called jumping. When you jump to some place, what happens? If you're simply walking, and what is the difference between jumping and walking? I'm asking you that English vocabulary. What is the difference in the meaning? Walk and jump. Anjo. So just imagine you are while looped as just walking. Inside the loop, each and every statement will be executed line by line, isn't it? Line by line execution, and again it is going for checking the condition, then again line by line execution. That line by line execution, we can consider it as walking. So what can be jumping? If that is walking, what can be jumping? You say something, Chris, Srihari.
Skip the line. Okay.
What happens?
Skip the line.
You are skipping some part and you are going to some other place, isn't it? When you jump from one place to another, or you are jumping from one floor to another floor, you are skipping that many parts, isn't it? And you are going to somewhere else. Okay, the same way, there is a set of statements called jump statements, which is used to jump the control, take the control from one place to another place, not to the next line. It can be to the next line, it can be after three lines, it can be after four lines. It is like a jumping from one place to another. That kind of statements, if you write that statement, the program control will jump. That is why they are called as jump statements. Mainly there are two jump statements in Python. One is break, another one is continue. One is break and another one is continue. So usually the program flow inside the loop is like walking line by line, but we can alter the control of the loop. using this jump statements. So there are two jump statements. The first jump statement is, first jump statement is, first jump statement is, what is the first jump statement? Break.
Break.
Second jump statement is continue. Okay, two statements are there. One is break, another one is continue. Now we'll give you an example. So the question is this. So listen carefully. I is equal to 1 while I less than or equal to 10. 10. I plus equal to 1. What will be the output of this program? Question to Gauri. What will be the output?
One, two, three, till 10.
1, 2.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
So one will be displayed. Gauri, one will be displayed. We have written
yes, ma'am. I is equal to 1.
So while I less than or equal to 10, directly we are giving a command I plus equal to 1. So I will be incremented to 2. So the output starts from 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9, 10. Okay, this is how your program works normally, isn't it? In that is why I told you, you have to know what is while loop. In while loop, when you give this statement, it works in that way. Now there are some situations where you need to skip some codes. So you are doing with I is equal to 1 to 10, but you don't want to continue the loop once we achieve some special condition. Say for example, when I becomes 7, you don't want to continue with the loop. When I becomes 7, you don't want to continue with the loop. So what do you need to do? Withhold. You should not change the program coding. Then Vithu will be telling to me that you change, ma'am, you change the condition to I less than or equal to 7. That is not possible without changing the program code. The program is like that itself. But when I become 7, I don't want to continue with the loop. I want to jump from the loop. I want to terminate the loop. So what you need to use? There comes our jump statement. So you can use a jump statement called break. If you use a jump statement break, then what will happen? Whenever we write this break, the entire control flow of the execution will jump from the loop. Okay? So that is the use of a break statement. Break statement breaks the loop. So what is the use of break statement? Break statement breaks the loop. It will go to the end of the while loop. Or you can say break statement is used to terminate a loop. Whenever it finds a break, that time itself it will terminate. So the break statement you are writing, B-R-E-A-K in small letters. So there is no other syntax. Simply you need to write break. So I'll be changing the question. So listen here. Here I am going to write. I plus equal to 1. That is remain same. If I equal to 7. What do you need to do? What do you need to do? What do you need to do, Vashish?
Break.
Break. So here it's a part of. Here you need to write break. Then the print statement we will write here. Now, Aditya Raj, what will be the output now? Think and just do it manually.
Ma'am, only 7 will be raised.
I can't hear you. Unmute. Whether 2 will be executed, 2 will be displayed?
Yes, 2 will be displayed.
Okay. 3 will be displayed?
Yes, ma'am.
4?
Yes, ma'am.
5?
Yes, ma'am.
6?
Yes, ma'am.
7. When on 7, what is the condition we are given here? If I is equal to 7. So in that case, I is 7. So what we have written inside if condition? Break. So whenever Python finds this break statement, the control will break from the loop. It will terminate the loop. It will terminate the loop. Because this print I statement is a part of while loop, isn't it? So the control will go out of the loop. So that is a speciality of break statement. So break statement skips certain statements. Which statement is skipped, Adul? Which
statement? Print statement.
Yeah?
Print statement.
Print statement is skipped. Not only skipped, the program will stop. Not the program, the while loop will stop. So Adul, tell me what will be the output now?
2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Atul.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
5, 6. This won't be executed. Because we have written a statement, when I is equal to 7, break. So it terminated, the loop got terminated. So no more execution of 7, 8, 9, 10. Any doubt in this break? Anyone has any doubt? Do you have any doubt?
No, ma'am.
No. So the next statement is continue. Next jump statement is continue. So we know that break statement is used to break from the loop. But continue statement, there is a difference. The difference is that continue statement will skip certain statements but continue with the loop. It skips few statements followed by this continue but continues with the loop. So there can be a question for your examination, even for the board examination. What is the difference between break and continue? So what is the difference? Break terminates the loop. Or it skips and it terminates the loop. But continue, it skips certain statements, but continue, it continues the loop. Okay, that is a major difference. Let's see with one example. Same question. So here I'm going to write continue. If I plus equal to 1, if I equal to 7, now let's see the difference. So when the first time when the program executes, I is equal to 1, while I less than or equal to 10. 1 less than or equal to 10, make now. 1 less than or equal to 10. Yes, so the loop body executes. What is the first statement inside the loop body? I plus equal to 1. So what is the new value of I?
1
became
2.
And what does the if condition given here? If I equal to 7, continue. Will it work? No, because I's value is 2. So if the if condition becomes false, the next statement will get executed. This statement will get executed. What is this statement? Print I. So what will be displayed on the screen? 2. Okay, then again, it will check for the condition. 2 less than or equal to 10, condition is true. It will enter into the loop body. Then now I becomes 3. If 3 equal to 7, condition is false, then print I. 3 will be displayed. Again, the loop condition will be checked. 3 less than or equal to 10, condition is true. 3 will become 4. 3 is equal to 7. Condition is false. Then print statement will get executed. 4 will be displayed. Again, it will go and check for the condition. 4 less than or equal to 10. Condition is true. 4 will become 5. If 5 is equal to 7. Condition is false. Print I. 5 will be displayed. Again, it will check for the condition. 5 less than or equal to 10. Evelyn, 5 less than or equal to 10. Condition is true. I will be incremented to 6. If 6 equal to 7, condition is false. Print I. Till here it's clear. Now, again it will go and check for the condition. I less than or equal to 10, that is 6. 6 less than or equal to 10, condition is true. Now 6 will become 7. Now I's value is 7. If 7 equal to 7, condition is true. So what it is written, what we have written inside? Continue. So when this continue statement executes, what happens is, it will skip the statements followed by this continue. So whatever statements are remaining inside the while loop body will be skipped. So which are statements are there inside the loop body now remaining? Only print I, isn't it? That is the only statement we have written as a part of the loop body. That will be skipped when you write continue, but the loop will be continued. Whenever it finds a continue statement, the statements under this continue, after this continue, inside the loop body will be skipped or will be avoided, but the loop continues. But the loop continues is very important. That is a major difference between a loop, a break statement and continue statement. So Amal Daj, tell me what will be the output. Unmute. So we got till 6. After that, Amal Raj.
Ma'am, when did you check? It will be false.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then?
Ma'am, 7.
7.
Ma'am,
Dia.
7 will not be printed.
After 6?
7 will not be printed.
7 won't be printed. Very good. Then it continues with the loop. So after 6?
8.
8? Come on. After
9?
9?
10.
So you can see the difference. When you write a break statement, you got a different output. When you wrote continue statement, we got a different output. So that is the major difference between break and continue. Any doubts in break and continue? Mohammad Irfan. Mohammad Irfan, any doubt? Elvina, Hanna, Lydia.
No, ma'am.
No doubt. Mohammad Irfan. Mohammad Irfan. Mohammad Irfan. He's not there. He went somewhere. Ran away. Mohammad Irfan. Mohammad Irfan, I will call you after this class, today itself. Or you call me. If you are hearing this, I want to talk to you. Shivani, turn on your video. Shivani. Not at the desk. Sharath, you tell me what is the difference between break and continue?
Break statement breaks the loop. And statement skips some statements and then continues the loop.
Not properly audible, but I guess it's correct. You are telling, whatever you're telling is correct. So that is the difference between continue and break. Now comes the one more thing I just want to tell you. So usually your while loop has a simple syntax that you know already. What is the syntax of while loop? You need an initialization expression. You need a test expression and a loop body and an update expression. Isn't it? That is a normal while loop. But actually, that is not the syntax. We have seen many programs and we have written many programs. That is the common syntax. But you have a original syntax for your while loop. So you write down the original syntax of while loop. So you will think that the other one is duplicate syntax. Not, it's a common syntax. But you have the syntax and you can skip a few portions are optional. That is why I thought I will teach you later. Only then we can move to the next program. That's why. So write down the syntax of wonderful. So let me take different backgrounds. Okay, syntax is initialization expression is same. Initialization expression. While condition, or it called as test expression. Full colon is compulsory. Statements, low body, update expression. There comes your extra thing, that is an optional syntax for while loop, that is the indentation is same as W. So this else is not a part of if condition. So don't get confused. This is else of whom? Evelyn, else of? Whose property this else? While loops. It is not if conditions. So while loop has this syntax. From else condition onwards, it is optional. And the question is, when this else condition will get executed? When it will get executed, Reina, what do you think? When it will get executed? Reina?
Yes, ma'am.
Take the mic. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
When will it execute? Reina.
Yes, ma'am, I can hear you.
You can't hear me?
I can hear you.
Then tell me the answer. My question is, you know how this, when this while condition and loop body and update statement, when it is getting executed. So, when this else will get executed, if you are writing this, it is an optional statement, you can skip it, but if you are writing the statement, when it will get executed? No idea.
At the first, ma'am.
Krishna Chandran? When will it get executed, Krishna Chandran? Any idea, anyone?
When the original condition is false.
When the while condition becomes false, the control will jump to this else. So whenever the condition is true, whenever the condition is true, these statements will get executed. True. Whenever this condition becomes false, this else, whatever we have written inside the else statement will get executed. Understood? Do you understand? Are you getting my point?
Yes.
Okay. And so normally it is like that. But when you have a break statement, inside It will, I told you, whenever you have a break statement inside the loop, it will terminate the loop. Terminate the loop means if I'm writing some break statement here, here I'm writing a break statement. Just as an example. Then what happens, Muhammad Adeem? When you write a break statement, there can be if condition, that doesn't matter. I'm just writing a break statement here. If we write a break statement here, what happens, Muhammad Adeem? Muhammad Adeem. To which case it will jump? I told you break is a jump statement. It will exit the while loop. So to which place it will jump? Hello, Muhammad.
I don't know.
Tell me, after that I have to wind up the class. Grishma. Nobody is responding. Pavitra. Anthony. Anthony. Ashwin Binan. Shivani. Ashwin, to which place it will be jumping to? Which place?
Else.
That's the difference. I told you else is a part of while loop. Whenever there is a break statement, it will terminate while loop. That means it will terminate every part of the while loop. This else condition is a part of while loop. So it jumps to the end. It will skip else also. Whenever you are writing a break statement, it will jump to this place. Okay? So if you are not writing a jump statement here, break statement here, else statement will get executed when the condition is false. But if you have a break statement, then the control will go to, control will skip else part also, and it will terminate while loop. Have you got confused? Have you got confused, Shivani? Emmanuel sitting as if I am teaching some complicated mathematical problem. Huh?
Oh,
yeah. Is it complicated? Emmanuel?
Oh, no.
If you attend the class regularly without absence, then you will understand better. Otherwise, always complicated things will be always complicated. It won't be getting simplified unless you try for that. So don't miss the classes. Again, I'm telling you, basics. It's like alphabets, A, B, C, D, E, F, G. You are going to learn new words now, how to write a sentence in English language. So basic things, don't skip the class. If you are skipping for an unavoidable reason, do watch the recorded video. Okay? So the break can continue. If you want, I will explain to you again. But I need to have a response from you. Only if you don't understand, I need to explain. If you are not responding, that means you understood everything. So I'll go with the next portion. Okay? That's all for today. And Muhammad Irfan, expect a call from me. Thank you.